It is indeed surprising that the U.S. ended up being the leading country in the number of coronaviruses, given the huge investment in preparedness all around the world that the U.S. had been financing. And it's a combination of factors, primarily, I think, an underestimation of the seriousness of the virus that goes back to the month of January when the cases were increasing in China. And the response needed to gear up. And there was a delay, a fatal delay, I would say, at the beginning of the pandemic that did not affect only the U.S., affected also other countries. And that very delay was the beginning of a response that was clearly not up to the level that many would have expected from a country like the U.S. This is not only a problem of the U.S. Testing has been one of the critical issues, one of the most sensitive issues around the world. And throughout this pandemic, we have not had enough tests being performed with the timeliness that is needed. You don't want a test result coming 5-6 days after the test. You want the results coming immediately. And we are not yet at that level. The U.S. has not been at that level. And so that has been a major issue. And that's why many scientists estimate that the number of cases in the U.S. and all around the world that have been registered is actually much lower than the actual number of cases. And by a factor of 2, 3, 5, some say even 10. So clearly the pandemic is a big pandemic. We have 20 million cases around the world, 5 a quarter in the U.S., and the pandemic is not slowing down. We are having every day almost a record on the number of cases daily. So we are around 300,000 cases per day in the world. There is a lot of progress. We have more than 200 vaccines that are in different phases of clinical trials and 10 that are towards the finish line. But getting towards the finish line and being licensed, it takes some time. So this is done at record speed all over the world, and I'm very confident we're going to get a vaccine, or probably more than one, in the next few months. The problem will be having the vaccine produced in huge quantities and being available for the entire world. I think it's safe to say that most likely this will happen, the distribution of vaccine will happen in 2021, as Dr. Fauci was mentioning earlier. In 2020, we may see a candidate arriving to the finish line, but actually it will be unlikely that people will be benefiting largely from it. So we'll have to wait a little bit more. And until that moment, as Dr. Fauci was saying in your previous interview, we need to focus on public health measures, on social distancing, on washing hands, wearing masks in all the places. And these measures can make a huge, huge difference for all of us in the U.S. and all around the world.